This is our first video, first vlog if you like. Then we didn't choose the best conditions to do it in really. It's pissing with rain, it's quite dark so you can't really see what either of us look like. I mean, yeah, that's pointing at Luke's head there. No chance of seeing who he is. But you can see a bit of the road, so I guess it's a good little place to start. We're on a nice evening jaunt out. We're going to go through Gomshall, nice little roads to Newlands Corner eventually. It's what I do on a Sunday on my motorbike. Will seems to have a motorbike. Because he has a car, which we're in at the moment. So yeah.
I think there's probably roadworks up there somewhere.
Yeah, there are the... oh shit, they closed the A24. But I think there might be overnight closed on the A24.
But down this road?
No, the Mickey Bend.
Yeah.
But I think it's only one way, and I know a shortcut home anyway, if they are.
If not, we can just go past my house and then down the down through.
Yeah, exactly.
Whatever it's called.
My favourite road.
Yeah.
The road that people crash quite a lot down.
Yeah, it's a fun road.
It's brilliant. It really is. It is, it's quite a nice drive. It's nice to go down on a low powered bike actually, just to get some real speed up on it.
Yeah, I think it goes 50, 50, 50, 30 when you get to Dorking. Yeah. Through Dorking Town.
Through Dorking
it's
Town.
A 30, then
it's a 30.
To, then you get to Gomshall and Amidou, which is a 30, and once you go past Gomshall, it's a 50 again. And then it goes up to National.
Yeah, but Gomshall is one of those 30s in inverted commas. I'm not saying kill all slow drivers, I think that's a bit drastic. But I think that if you're not confident to do the posted speed... But I got stuck behind a driver, actually it was on this road earlier, doing 35 miles an hour.
Down a 50.
Down a 50, and I just think you're holding everyone up.
But it should be the same as the tractor rule. If you've got more than 15 cars behind you, pull over, let everyone go past.
Well, it should be the rule. I mean, it's not just the tractor rule, that's what they tell you to do...
basically all the time.
If you're on a moped or a motorbike.
Yeah. If you're slow, if you're a slow-moving vehicle, you should pull over. When there's a significant amount of cars behind you, because it's in zero.
But the thing is, they don't realise it,
exactly.
A lot of them, because they're so past it. Not that we have anything against elderly drivers.
It is mainly elderly drivers.
It's quite often.
But the way the elderly driver thing works, they just don't retest or anything. There's no way of determining.
I mean,
the only way of determining when an old person has gone beyond the point of being able to drive is when they have a crash.
Exactly. You know, I don't think they should necessarily have to do a full driving test again.
No, right? just competency, eyesight.
Yeah, a little driving competency test. Like the old motorbike test, really. Just, you know, around the block with an instructor. Because it's quite quick and easy to ascertain whether someone is safe to be driving.
Yeah.
I know the DVLA like to go
all out
on it. Have you ever had an eye condition? You know, you have to declare virtually everything these days. I mean, I remember when I was getting my license, I had to declare my... like Asperger's and stuff, and they took that into consideration as to whether I could actually have a license, and the fact that I have Tourette's as well.
They didn't seem
to notice the Tourette's. When you're concentrating, it goes away. You know, they don't notice that. They just see that you have little motor tics and stuff. But hey ho, you got it through in the end.
Well, did you have trouble getting a license?
They were reluctant. I had to get a doctor's say so. Oh, you're asleep. I will point out it is nearly 1 a.m.
It is 10 to 1.
There is the centre of the universe. It's dark so you can't really see it, but that's right because that's where I was earlier. Because it's a Sunday. Well, it's actually technically a Monday.
It's Monday now.
It's nice to see the beginning of bike season. Of course, this weather is completely different.
This weather isn't ideal for bikes. This is why I don't have a bike.
It came about quite unexpectedly. This weather. It was lovely and sunny earlier.
Understand about road works. They block the road off.
And then they proceed to not do it.
Yeah, no, I
don't. Different council job, really, innit?
Yeah. Yeah, it takes about 6 weeks to fill a single pothole. That sort of thing.
Yeah, that one. If you go right here. Yeah. Nifty little shortcut.
Oh, yeah, I know. Goes past the school.
Mm-hmm. Also goes past your favourite road.
Oh yeah, Ranmore Common Road.
Ranmore Common Road, yeah.
Great road. Wish it was a 50 or a 60.
They used to be 50.
They used to be
50.
They used to be.
Yeah.
It holds water on those dips. If it's wet, it's not a good wet driving road. It's a good summer road.
I really don't know what bike to get next. It's so it's becoming a bit of a vexing issue. And I know the kind of roads that I like, and I know what sort of bikes are for those, but I don't know, they just look a bit samey, really. They're all a bit boring. That way. Which I should give you some guidance there, I suppose. Seeing as it's my fault you went this way anyway.
It's come down that triangle stores, isn't it?
Right next to triangle stores.
Dorking now.
Dorking. Are we going to see the giant cock? No, I think we've managed to bypass the giant cock.
Bypass the cock, yeah.
That's a shame. Right.
Is the cock wearing anything at the moment?
I haven't seen him for a little while.
Last time I saw him, he wasn't wearing anything. Are there any events that are happening? Would there be any reason for him to have anything on him?
I can't think of anything. Oh, I've fallen asleep.
Wait, can I turn that way?
Oh, it's not like I've got work early tomorrow.
Is it still one-way system or can I go that way? Can I turn that way, can't I? Yeah,
one-way
system starts there.
Yeah, I knew that.
This isn't a bad car.
It's not a bad car.
It just looks something that can go a bit faster.
For 1.4 it's pretty decent.
Yeah,
to be honest.
Especially with the roof system in the boot.
Right. I need to make camcorders for left-handed people, I'm just saying. I'm sure they do it actually. Oh, there's some shady biz going on in that car.
Yeah, there was. Saw a car.
Car with its interior lights on and steamy windows. Yeah.
And shadows.
Legit.
Not next to each other. Things you see in the Surrey Hills at 1 in the morning on a Monday.
Well, it is most popular county for dogging in England.
So Ockham Bites Cafe down by your house down the station.
Ockham Bites is probably the worst.
Yeah, it is.
Bloody hell.
It's a price spectrum, isn't it, to be fair?
Well, I think it's a bit built up, the spectrum.
This sort of outskirts
of Gombshaw.
There's a nice little waterfall down here somewhere.
Yeah, there is. It's a very pretty place actually if you go for a walk.
Yeah.
I've
had a look online because I was showing someone else to my camera, taking them out down by Friday Street.
That's a big old rig, isn't it?
But yeah, it's not far from here. Doing the speed limit
then. Oh, definitely.
Do a Jeremy Clarkson and get a shot of the speedo doing 40.
Oh, that was a funny episode there. And with the use of computer trickery, we could do 50 miles an hour. Yeah. That's the sort of 50 miles an hour I usually do.
50 miles an hour?
Yeah, about 45.
What, stuck behind the idiot drivers, he can't go?
No, on this hill my bike could go down 45 anyway.
I'm like, I'm struggling. I got stuck on a hill yesterday, I was being goggling. There was a hill, it's like, it goes up, like, see where those red pillar things are? Imagine a hill going off to the left up there.
God, I remember taking my C90 up Berry Hill near Bognor. Woohoo! It was interesting to say the least. It did not want to do Berry Hill.
I imagine that the C90 wouldn't. It decided to kill you quite a few times, didn't it?
It did try.
Is that the one that killed you? Or tried to kill you?
Yeah, no, numerous times.
Yeah. So yeah, this hill, I was trying to get up.
Leith Hill is lovely.
I was in first gear, going up maybe a 30% incline. And I was doing 3,500 revs and it just wasn't going anywhere.
Lovely.
And I had to get it up to 4,500 before it moved.
Well, it's even my bike will do that. The 125.
What bike got to 9,000 revs?
I think that's rev limit at 11.
No.
But it's a little tiny engine, short stroke. Oh,
that
shit! That was a bit of a puddle. Jesus Christ. Yeah, no, that's where Rio quite famously broke down. That's where Rio broke down on his CBR that he had for 2 days.
The CBR he had for 2 days?
Yeah.
What? The one the Mad Max one that crashed?
Yeah, the Mad Max one.
That was a CBR?
Oh, that was a CBR. That was a very modified CBR.
Yeah. Nice.
I wanted that. I wanted that bike.
What happened to it? It fell apart,
He crashed it and just...
Did he crash it or did it just disintegrate?
Well, it sort of disintegrated, I don't know. You know.
Oh, there is life.
There is another vehicle.
Yeah, and it's probably a good idea to slow down
there. Nah, it's not a copper. Not a copper.
Yeah, it is.
Is it?
Yeah, it is. Focus or Fiesta or something, but it had the markings on the back.
Oh, good.
On the boot. Worried it was turning around to follow me because
that would make a great first video.
There's a lot of water coming this way now.
Yeah, I've ridden through worse. I remember riding through a field on my Suzuki. That was alright until I changed the carburetor.
Oh, that was a fun experience having the Ford. Not the car, the water.
Yeah, the water.
Yeah, there was a sub-zero.
Oh, you told me about this.
Where there was a ford and you had to go down and then up the other side, and you know, water and coal doesn't really go very well together, and you end up just sliding.
Yeah, I do love.
Didn't hit anything, but it took about 4 attempts to get the car up on the other side, and the wheels just span. Apparently, I was doing 80 mile an hour up that tiny little hill.
I remember once taking my my little Suzuki through what can only be described as an extremely deep puddle. Extremely deep puddle. And it was actually, I had a friend on YBR behind me. And I go through the puddle absolutely fine, get to the other side. And, because I was on my way home. But my friend's only going to follow me on the YBR and drowns the fucking thing. Now the air intake on my bike's a bit higher up than the old YBR. And suck a load of water into the engine. It's a beautiful thing about those sorts of bikes though is, drain the oil out, sort it all out, and usually it won't notice. Built to last them things. We're here at Newlands, probably full of. There are actually headlights.
No, they're around there. It's the lights around the toilets.
Oh, good. I was going to say, it's probably full of.
They are implementing parking charges here, did you hear?
They are, I have heard that.
They have been given the green light to implement parking charges
here. Yeah, they will be.
They will be, yeah.
There's no stopping them sort of thing.
Well, the place is owned by the National Woodland Trust, I believe.
Yeah, no, it's not National
it's
Trust.
Not, no, it's not. It's, yeah. Yeah, it's the Woodlands Trust. And,
but, I mean, that was a huge petition.
They decided it would be a good idea to do it before they went to public vote or something and just didn't listen to the public at all. And now they're going to be charging like £4 a day to park here.
Yeah, no, it's expensive. And I don't know whether it's, I don't really know whether there's any truth in it, but I heard they're going to try and charge bikes as well, which,
you can't charge bikes, can you? Is there anywhere that charges bikes?
There are a few little bits and places, mostly in London though. I know exactly what will happen if they start trying to charge bikes is...
They're out of business.
Well, exactly,
drive away all the customers.
Well, the truth of the matter is, the customers for this place, the Burger Bar, and the Burger Bar. The Burger Bar is an independent thing. It's family owned. So it's them that are getting shafted over, really.
Yeah.
As well as the customers. Everyone's just going to go. Well, all the bikers.
Going to go to Rikers.
All the bikers just going to go down to Box Hill if they implement parking charges.
Exactly.
It's one of the few places left in Surrey where you can. There's no such thing as a free day out anymore, is there?
Exactly.
There's no such thing as... they're trying to encourage people, get out in nature, go out and...
And then they charge you to park there.
And they charge you to park there. And then, they're charging you to walk and be green and, get your exercise. And I just think there's something quite morally wrong about that. I mean, let's be honest, the charities that own this place, they are not poor. It's just got very foggy. Very foggy all of a sudden.
That was... quite ominous.
This is where me and Rio saw that really weird thing up in the sky.
Oh yeah, what, the green thing?
Yeah, the green thing. No, honestly, I can't stress to you
You get a bloody good view up here, yeah?
Yeah.
The sky, for as far as you can see, we were standing over...
By the thing.
Over where all the bikes park.
Just
over there, standing over where all the bikes park, yeah? So if you look up, you've got a view. You can see all the way... a complete clear view. The whole sky was green, and it moved from over there to all the way over there, disappeared over the horizon. It was really unusual.
Hmm. Yeah, it is really weird. I don't know what would cause that.
Turned freezing cold as well.
Really?
Yeah.
Right after it happened?
No, before it about 5 minutes before it happened, it turned freezing cold.
Oh.
Then, like, so cold all the hairs on the back of your neck stand up.
Yeah, I've got that right now.
Yeah, me too, I've got that right now. You know, you don't think anything of it. Suddenly this almighty green flash.
Did you hear anything? Was it loud?
No, it's silent.
Oh.
Almighty green flash in the sky, and it moves. It moves through the sky.
So what, there was a centre... dot of green?
No, there wasn't. It was like a line. It was like a line that moved over the sky as far as you can see from all the way over there and straight over and down over the horizon.
Is this if a jet flew over?
No, because the whole sky. It was like a line across the whole sky.
Hmm.
It was very unusual. And, yeah, no, it turns freezing cold. And then, strangest thing happens, the second it's gone, the second it's sort of disappeared and it's all gone back to darkness, the warmth comes back.
Oh.
Just there, snap. It's not like it gradually warms up, the warmth is back. And I don't know whether we had just been talking for quite a long time or something. It felt like about 15 minutes had passed since we last checked the clock, and an hour and 15 minutes had passed. So it was a bit weird that one.
Keep going.
Yeah, let's move.
Go.
Feels something creepy happened.
Yeah.
It feels like sort of night when something creepy would happen.
Yeah, it does.
It's got so foggy since we pulled in.
I don't really understand what my brain wants to do, because it'll be like, oh, I want to know this creepy shit, but then also...
Yeah, it's
really
ditto. My brain will be like, you must know this creepy bullshit, but you will not sleep.
Yeah. And I always find myself talking about it.
Well, I love going on the websites and looking up sort of like...
The ghosts on the A3 and stuff.
Yeah, yeah, no, I love that. I mean, my story of that ghost, the ghost lights I saw.
Yeah.
And that's not talk about ghost lights. Yeah, loads of people have seen those. And I still really don't believe in that kind of thing. I don't know if it's like spirit, I don't really buy the whole spirits of the departed thing. But you know, lots of people down that particular road have seen the same optical phenomena that I saw, which is, we're about to go down that road actually, which is a pair of tail lights in front of you that,
drive straight off the road.
Yeah, they drive straight off the road. It doesn't matter how fast you're going, you never catch up with them. Really quite old looking car. Literally, you can accelerate and they don't get any closer. You can brake.
Same sort of phenomenon as a rainbow.
You can brake, they don't get any further away. Then you see them go off the road and you hear a great big crash.
And they're gone.
Yeah, they're gone. No, investigate, there's no crash, no wreckage, no nothing. And
Were you on the A3 when you saw that, or were you going across the
bridge? That was the A246.
It was the
A3. No, there is an A3 ghost as well.
Yeah, that's the one I saw.
The one
that's
I personally...
you sent me.
Yeah. The one I personally saw is the A246 ghost. There's also one on the Hindhead Tunnel as well. Not the Hindhead Tunnel.
Yeah.
Basically before the Hindhead... Oh, bloody hell, that's a big puddle. Basically before the Hindhead Tunnel was constructed around the Devil's Punch Bowl. That road, lots of people saw... saw ghosts and appearances. Again, it was a phantom car.
Really?
Yeah. There's the woman in white that's quite often seen in Fetchham as well.
Really? Fetchham?
Yeah. There, you know the road long from Effingham Junction Bridge?
Yeah. What, the one that goes down past the car garage? Down towards the drift? Or the other way?
So, the road with the bridge on it.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah.
A bit like a cold garage up here.
Yep, Burnham Colville.
And a lovely road down to the left there, the roundabout.
Yeah, no, it's a nice road. That's actually quite nice on the bike as well.
Ripley Lane.
Bit pothole-y, but...
Yeah, it's a little
bit pothole-y,
but the road's relatively wide, so you can go quite fast.
Yeah, no. This is where the tail lights started coming into view.
What? Going up here?
Yep, going up here. Again, that was another very cold night. Like,
really?
Yeah. And it was really late, you know, because I'd been at my then girlfriend's house until about 3 a.m. So, and she lived in Farnham, so you can only imagine just how long through the night I'd been going. So it could have been exhausting to make me see it, to be honest.
I don't know.
Always creeps me out that light in that driveway there.
I know.
Oh water. Shit, that's water.
It doesn't creep me out that light. It just worries me that there's police following me.
Yeah, no. I always think, was that a cop or is that?
Yeah,
a cop?
Just waiting. Yeah. Because I've seen down at Dobbs, there's a an M3
sits there all
sometimes
the time.
Sits yeah. There.
Okay.
Yeah, if you do live in Surrey, this vlog might be quite useful if you want to speed and get away with it.
Yeah, no, don't come down this road. It's always cops.
Always cops.
Always cops down this road.
I've been pulled twice on this road.
Yeah, I've been pulled once on this road. For doing nothing.
Once with you in the car.
Yeah, no, I remember.
When we got accused of stealing stuff. Or not accused of stealing stuff. Pulled because they thought we were stealing stuff.
Yeah. Not really the ultimate getaway car, this.
Not really, no.
You know, that's another lovely road up there.
Yeah, off to the right, yeah.
Yeah, no.
Now this is another annoying road because there's always people on it because it's the main part of the 246. Always congested, but like not enough to go slow. And then you do about this sort of speed at 40, 45, and it's got behind you. I got pulled over on the right there, watch the lights.
Yeah, no, I remember that.
Go the other way.
Well, we'd just come out of
down where the Grange is, Rectory Lane.
So actually, that cop car did follow us for quite a while.
Yeah, it was following us for a while. And he said I was going way over and going over enough to lose my license.
I don't know that. We weren't going
that
fast.
Much, no. Because this is a 40, and I wasn't doing much faster than this. This is 40 now, I wasn't doing much faster than this.
Yeah.
And Rectory Lane, the first bit is a 30 and then it goes to 40.
Mm.
And I couldn't have been doing more than 10 over. That's where the M4 or the M3 sits.
Yeah, in there. Dobbs Garden Centre, the entrance exit. So I guess it is probably time to stop recording now.
That's probably a good idea, yeah.
Say goodbye. Yeah. So this is our first little video. Hope you've enjoyed us just sort of chattering away to each other, and
there will be slightly more interesting stuff happening.
Yeah, there will be.
In the next,
I'm sure, in the next videos. This was literally just a tester to get into it, sort of thing. Obviously, we need to do something with the filming and setup because I have a very dead arm. Thank you very much for watching, if you watch, and see you next time.